info, guys. So Joey is actually gonna attempt to hold this trailer with the Land Cruiser. Let's go.
Runs like shit.
Runs like dog doo-doo. For a pressure regulator tester.
Oh, beautiful
shot. So I know my side was clean when I left here.
Dang it, really.
Oh, okay.
Perfect, huh?
Yeah, that's perfect.
Test doesn't sound like good, but it's okay.
it's totally fine. So me and my brother are out here messing around. Trying to figure out why this thing runs so rough.
Runs like shit.
Runs like dog doo doo.
Don't run like a 22R, I can tell you that.
But Joey's betting all his money that it's the temperature set sensor.
It's a good lead.
Oh yeah, good lead.
Good lead.
I think it's still gonna run like dog doo doo.
You think so?
I think so. We'll see.
I don't know why it does that.
So we just put the new temperature sensor in there. I feel like with my luck, it's not gonna fix it. But Joey thinks it is. This truck, so it ran like crap before. But it just did it randomly. So we're thinking it was the temperature sensor.
Before.
What's up, guys? Happy Father's Day. It's the next day, Father's Day today. So I didn't really explain what we were doing. Brother just kind of came over randomly and just figured I'd start recording. But what we were trying to do yesterday, so a problem that I've had with this motor, it runs fine, but for some reason it runs rich. And whenever you turn it off, and let's just say like you leave it for like 10 minutes or something like that, you know, you ride a trail, get out, talk for a minute, you get back in it, it takes a minute for it to crank up. I almost thought it had a stuck injector, leaking injector, something like that. Well, kind of a, we started off by replacing the coolant temp sensor. Easy thing, you know, easy little switch it out, blah blah blah. We tried that. It didn't seem like it did anything. And then we kind of turned our head to maybe the TPS sensor back here. Maybe that had something to do with it. Not sure. This thing has always had a high idle. It'll idle around 1,000. It won't go much lower than that for some reason. I'm not sure. But the thing with the 3.4, it's all computer controlled. There's no kind of idle adjustment or anything like that. It's all controlled by the, I believe it's this guy right here. The IVC controller or something like that. I'm pretty sure that's what controls the idle of it. But like I said, the main problem is it has a tough time starting up after you've actually started up. And before I get ahead of myself, we went and got this guy. It's a fuel pressure tester. I just hooked it up into my feed line right here just to see that we had good fuel pressure, which we do. We got 40 PSI all around. So that's good. We're not getting way too much fuel. But like I said, I haven't cranked it up. I'm about to crank it up and see what she does. Acts like it has fuel in it. Run like this for a minute and then it'll clean out.
Crank it up.
It smells like straight fuel, like there's fuel in the cylinder. So I'm almost wondering if I have fuel stuck in there.
You can see now.
It's cleaned up. It only does this on startup. After it does that, it acts fine. But I just wanted to come out here and kind of explain what we were doing. I've come to realize trying to plan videos, it just ain't happening with me. the stuff that we do is just, it just comes on the fly. But today's Father's Day, so I'm going to just go spend some time with my father, which, for anyone who's watching, go spend time with your father. But happy Father's Day. I'll be right back. Editor's note, just wanted to go ahead and apologize for the rest of this video. I didn't really explain a whole lot of what we were doing. I explained a little bit towards the end of the video, but basically we were just trying to get this done, reassembling the knuckles, and get it out from my brother Joey's driveway. He had already gone through and did some of the important stuffs like the inner seals and put in the locker in the front axle, but I think I explained some of that the rest of this video. But just wanted to apologize real quick, but enjoy the rest of the video.
It looks like we're on the right track.
Perfect.
There.
Now she is off the jacks. We still got a little bit to do. We're going to be taking some stuff off, like the shocks, and cleaning that up a bit. We're going to be buffing on the front bumper, try to get stuff repainted, make freshen it up, look nice, and we're going to start buffing on this thing, try to make it look pretty. And might touch up some other stuff on here. But all the main stuff that we want to get done today. Sorry, I haven't been talking much. We've been trying to knock this out, get it done, so that way this thing rolls again. That way we can move it in and out of here, because it's just been sitting here while we've been waiting. Something my brother Joey had already done. He took the trunk out and he actually put a lunchbox locker in it. Ain't that right, Joseph? No idea what that is, David. No idea.